Kwasi Nnamdi Kanu is in need of your help. If you back him up, you have a lot to gain. Let me make it clear. It is all about what the British government has got to lose and what they have got to gain. Because this trouble is getting started. Now, if we get Biafra, without Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, Britain has everything to lose.
You're right.
I want to make it clear.
Yes.
I want to make it clear. Let them take note of this. Our people say, Tabubu, today is still early. And Enyim na ngwara ga agwa be ezigbo enyi. And Enyim na maka agwa ga agwa agwa enyi. In other words, I told you so. Always comes from a true friend. Britain has to do whatever they can to make sure that we get Biafra under Mazi Nnamdi Kanu
now,
so that there will be a working relationship between British people and Biafrans and Oduduwas.
Yes.
If we get Biafra without Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, Britain has everything to lose. Because it doesn't matter how long it takes, this is going to be a generational struggle. And we are not giving up until we get what we want. The sooner they do the needful, the sooner they do the needful and get Mazi Nnamdi Kanu out, and possibly start negotiating some kind of relationship between Britain, Biafra and Oduduwa, the better for Britain. Not for us, the better for them. If they continue the kind of shenanigans they are playing game with us, and then something happens along the line, and we realize Biafra without Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, things will be extremely different for Britain.
And
take it from me. This is a candid advice from an inside knowledge of who Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu has a lot of plans for the future, not just for Biafrans, Oduduwas, Middle Beltans, but also for British people. But if they lose this opportunity and it goes, generations will wake up and say, what happened? How did we lose this opportunity? Because it can never, Britain can hardly survive it. Once again, we are fighting for the referendum. We are not fighting for war. We are not asking for war. We are asking for referendum. Above all, free Mazi Nnamdi Kanu now. Free Mazi Nnamdi Kanu
now.
Free Mazi Nnamdi Kanu
now.
As free Sunday Boho
now.
Free Sunday Boho
now.
Free Sunday Boho
now.
And see what dialogue we can have with them when they come out for the betterment of British people and their future generation.
Thank you.
All hail Biafra.
All hail Biafra.
All hail Oduduwa.
All hail Oduduwa.
Thank you very much.
All right, okay. I just came back.
Can you imagine you are just 5% and 5% of the people want to love each other, 95% of the people. How can that happen? Now, the upgraded to 40 million. There are 40 million in Nigeria. No way. So, today, we are sending that message that enough is enough. Today, we saw 5 presented to them. Standing before us in solidarity for this struggle. Today, we see all the others here. Today, we see all the people who are here. Today, now, it's destiny that the struggle is coming in full swing. In 2 weeks time, we'll be calling you. We'll come back again. Let's hear from another. All Biafra.
All
Oduduwa.
All Oduduwa.
I want to thank all of you here. When you look at the number,
those who are very enthusiastic for this move. How many of us are here in New York? People came from many states to support what we are doing. So I want to thank all of you. Do not lose hope. Whoever will come here, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Kano will be released in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Ibo will be released in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Do not lose hope. We are getting there. So I want to thank you and thank all those who have spoken on Augustine, all the priests here. So I want to encourage all of you, whenever we have this time of gathering, let us come in mass and support Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are all getting it. We shall all get Biafra. All have Biafra.
All
have Biafra.
All have Biafra.
God bless you. As we put it on record, that ready today is not only for people from New York. We have people from Maryland, we have people from Boston, we have people from Washington D.C., we have the people from their brothers and sisters from New Jersey, and tomorrow, 24th, that another rally downtown will work. Please, gentlemen, we want to be down there. We can never stop until it starts by 11 o'clock in the morning, downtown will work. Please, we can never stop.
Yes.
5% of the people cannot carry each other, 95% of the people.
Never.
That has never happened anymore.
Yes. Never.
We must put a stamp to put on the oligarchy. The economy, they said that Nigeria is given to them by God. I don't know who they are God. It's not over. All have the offer. All have the offer. The struggle continues. Let's stop. Brother, here you are. All hail Biafra!
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 Biafra, we heard you. We are here today because of all hail Oduduwa!
All hail Oduduwa!
All hail Oduduwa!
All hail Oduduwa!
All hail Biafra!
All hail Biafra!
The observation. We are here today because Maazi Nnamdi Kanu, God's servant, Elohim's servant, he was kidnapped in Kenya for $1 billion that people contributed to do that evil. We are telling Britain that Britain has turned us into a terrorist country. We are asking those who are performing this that they either listen to Kano or perish, because Elohim is an answer. We are looking at people like Ifeanyi Uba, Ebiano, Emeka Ofa. You are telling this, and I will tell you, we care how many of you were expected. And unfortunately, you have failed, not going to survive. You can't touch him because LM is with you. Biafra has come, you can't stop Biafra's. Either you give us before, these are two options now. Niger has to give before, or they'll perish. They're already perishing already. What that means is anything that stands in the front of the system against your front, they die. That's what he has told us to do. We are doing the will of Elohim. The self-control should be restored. All the front institutions have to be restored immediately. We are going backward. We are moving forward. Forever, backward ever. Kenya is a terrorist nation. Has been a kidnapper. Whose character is a kidnapper? Fulani is a terrorist. Fulani is a terrorist, and we're all walking away. They betrayed our warriors in the forest. Yes, sir. God bless yes, sir. God bless IPOB. God bless Biafra.
Yes.
God bless all freedom lovers. We are saying, God bless Oduduwa. God bless all of you here. And those who are here, we shall go push forward. We shall go pray and fast and rest with us. Biafra is here. God bless you, thank you. I stand here, we have 30 minutes for our permit to be here. We have the two speakers again. We sing our song. We have Peter. I don't know how to introduce him. He introduced himself. And then talk to us. We have Ezekiel who speak to us. We see standing by. And then we sing one more song and go down there back and forth twice before getting the prayers.
All right, I don't really
I don't really know what to say. I've spoken so much on radio, I've lost a word. But my name, let me introduce myself properly. My name is Ike Peters. I broadcast on Radio Biafra too, every day. And it's nice to be here with you guys. You see, a lot of people that I've met today, I'm so happy, I'm so thrilled. Because these are people I've been speaking for years on phone. I've never seen them in person. And now that I see them, I'm very happy. All hail Biafra! All hail Biafra! All hail Oduduwa! All hail Oduduwa! All hail Oduduwa! Let's carry on what we are doing. Thank you all.
And Peters! And Peters is here! You see, I think that the video is not a video coverage. When you have been, what are you doing in video coverage? The radio Biafra is starting live. Let's get our leader here. It's down. The only one, the gentleman that doesn't like to speak, but when you speak, it makes sense. I'm glad you're talking about it, but I love my club.
Talk about it.
Oh, hey, Biafra.
Oh,
hey, Biafra.
Oh,
hey, Biafra.
Oh,
hey, Biafra.
Oh,
hey, Biafra. Oh, hey, Oduduwa. Oh, hey, Oduduwa. My brothers and sisters, I'm overjoyed today. For years, we've been organizing rallies here, Biafra rallies. And at no time have I seen the kind of turnout there. What it means, the message is beginning to percolate.
Yes.
To sink.
Yes.
The people that said before that they didn't see anything wrong, now are beginning to see what is wrong. Those that had their heads in the sand over the years, gradually sticking out of the sand. And now we have our brothers, the Yorubas, joining us in solidarity. A few years ago, who could have thought that possible a few years ago? So we thank God for this development. And we credit this struggle, the Biafran struggle, for waking up all Nigerians of the southern, in the southern belt. From the middle belt down to the Delta. It is the Biafran struggle that woke them all up, that made them conscious of what the Fulanis are planning in Nigeria, are doing in Nigeria. The fact that they have cornered our country, they've taken over all the key levels of governance in Nigeria. Just mention it. They have it now. The Senate, the Federal House are all lopsided in their favor. You cannot pass one bill in any of the federal house that is not in the interest of the North. You cannot pass it because the deck is stacked in their favor. So how can we rely? When I hear people say, oh, we're going to restructure Nigeria and we're going to rely on the Senate and the federal house to do that, I'm like, are you out of your freaking mind? How could that happen? Somebody has already decked you up. Somebody has already put it in place, a system that will make it impossible for you to destruction Nigeria. Because the only way you can do that is, you know, you knock them dead and then do it overnight. And that's no way that's going to happen. So we cannot rely on the Nigerian political process to destruction Nigeria, because they won't let you do that. Nobody gives up power willingly. Nobody does that. You have to fight for it. You have to grab it. And that's what this struggle is about. And I'm telling you here today, with what is happening in Nigeria today, these people have taken off their gloves. Now they do not care anymore about what the southern part of Nigeria are doing. With their Ruga, with their cattle colony, with all the land grabbing that they're doing, bringing all the Fulanis from across Africa and the Sahel to come. And we hear them telling us that every Fulani man is their brother and they have the right to come and settle in Nigeria.
Anywhere.
And your president is building, a railway over here. And he's defending it. And you call that your country?
No.
That's no longer our country. It is their country. They can take it and do whatever they want with it. We want no part of it. All we're asking for is the freedom for Biafrans and the freedom for the people. That's what we're fighting for. And I want to use this opportunity to tell you that our goal is to organize at least one rally every month.
Yes.
Until victory is achieved.
That's right.
And I want all of us to join hands in making sure that those rallies are successful and even more successful than what we had here today. Again, please spread the word. We can no longer afford to sit on the fence. The time for sitting on the fence is over. Our children's future is at stake. The lives of generations of our children unborn is at stake. We don't have a homeland right now. It's not safe, it's not protected, it's not secured for them, for our children. And if we don't fight now to change that, they say it's too late to cry when the head is off.
Yes.
This is the time to cry.
Yes.
And that's what we're doing here.
Yes.
And we're doing it right in front of the British Embassy. They got us in this mess. We all know that they are the hand that wove this evil plan, evil plot, with the amalgamation and all they did, and they handed Nigeria over to the Fulani. And they've been helping them all these years to maintain power in Nigeria. That time is over. That time is over. So please, I thank all of you. Okay? We have limited time. After I'm done, we're going to do our normal marching and singing so we can take this to the end. But please, from the bottom of my heart, I thank each and every one of you that answered this call to today. Let's remember that the reason you and I are here in this country today is because of the struggle of African Americans. The reason we are here as blacks in this country today enjoying equal rights with the white people who colonized us is because of the struggle of our African American brothers and sisters. And they're still fighting here today. If it's not for a civil rights struggle that gave us the right, you and I will not be here today. They perfected the art of protest, of rallies, of demonstration, and we must learn from them. We must learn from them. If you kill one black man, it doesn't matter where in this country, all the blacks all over the country will go there to demonstrate. But it's hard to get our people to come off one day from work to come and protest. We must change that. If we want to change the fortunes of our people at home, the plight of our people at home, we must begin to sacrifice time.
Yes,
call up from work if there's a rally. We all, most of us here have jobs that, and we have been working for a long time. You can afford to tell your job, I'm not going to be in on Wednesday next week. Okay? No, you don't have to tell them why. Okay? But you know why. If we don't send our people back home, we are finished. They are finished. They're looking up to us. We are here enjoying the freedom that they don't have over there. So please, whenever we call our next rally, our rallies, make time. Don't make it an afterthought. Make it the only thing you have for that day. The only job you have on that day will be to attend the rally. Spread the word and tell other people. Give other people the good message. That our freedom is coming. Our freedom is coming. Our freedom is coming. And we are the one that make it happen. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you very much.
We have to fight this or lose it forever.
I'm happy to listen to you.
Or maybe I don't watch live. You know what? I don't watch live.
Okay, exactly.
I
watch, yeah.
You do it midnight, right?
No, 7 a.m. in the morning. Yeah. I know.
Maybe that's why.
7 a.m. I wake up 7. In fact, it used to be 6 because of the time. No, move on time. So we went to 7. Otherwise, 6 a.m. Yeah.
What's the number? You're gonna call. If I
call the number all the time. I don't, if you listen to it live, you'll get the number.
Okay. It's not like I have to log in to the website.
No, no. You have to call in when you are listening to it live on
air. Do you have the number? Is this the number?
I can't remember the number. I might give you my own number.
Okay.
Then you can call me and tell me.
Okay, sounds better.
Yeah.
I enjoy your sandwich. Is hell? I don't want people not buying it too. I know crazy people do call it too.
I know. There are two ladies I met here. I said, oh my God, I've been listening to you for 1 year and I've seen you for the first time. I said, well, that's really 845. 845-283. 9665. That's my personal line.
Oh, okay.
You don't use this to call me. But if you call me, I'll send you the numbers.
Oh, okay.
I'll text you.
Or if I text you, please can I?
Yes.
My name is Daniel. Chukwudi Obonna. Omenu Bukano.
Oh, okay.
My pleasure. All help you.
All
help you. I'm not a
friend. They have no choice.
Now, friend, work out. Look, I almost have a heart attack.
They have no choice.
I don't believe it's true.
I know.
I don't believe it's true, but God help us.
All right, I think, guys, you know, I left up before and I came back because some special people have come in to speak, and I gave them a hug. I felt it was nice to have them to speak. And right now, I think it's time for me to actually cut off. It's happening. It's still here. People are still very much. Reverend Father who spoke, Father Austin Medwa, very well, and for God before I came back. I came back because of that. And now that he has spoken, I don't even know where he is anymore. It's about time that we are planning on having this more regularly. I've never seen this kind of turnout in New York before. It's amazing. But that's what it's all about. The longer the delay, the more we get more people coming in. The more we are
doing.
So nice. I'm so happy about this whole turnout. So I have to go back. Tomorrow morning, I promise you, I'll be on air with you guys. And we'll talk more about this. For those of you who have time to chat and to watch, wow, right on my table. Somebody texted me, right on my people. Somebody that I know. Somebody that I like. I know. We move forward. We're still moving, my brother. There are no two ways about it. The Afra is here to stay, regardless of what anybody says. We are here. We will be here, whether they like it or not. They have no choice. The only choice they have is to give us the Afra. I'm happy also to learn that regardless of whatever happens, they will be in court on Monday. So whether they're taking a transfer leave or they're leaving or whatever they're doing, they either give us Biafra or we all die getting Biafra. They have no choice. The more they delay it, the more we have more people coming in. And it is happening. Everybody is supporting what we are doing. So beautiful. This is the first time I'm seeing so many people in locations, blessing the occasion that we are doing.
I don't know what other way to describe it. Let me just walk around and see if I can talk to a few more people. See if I can see a few more people and talk to them and see, have them speak to me. I can't believe it. These are my people here in New York. Free Nnamdi Kanu, a victim of an extraordinary rendition, a Biafran British citizen held tortured in Nigeria. I love this.
Thank you.
Very.
Glad to see your presence here.
Thank you. All right. So there are people here, I speak to them on phone all the time. I've not had the opportunity of seeing them live. But today, this is a very big opportunity, and I believe and I hope we have more of this, because they already promised that we're going to be having it more frequently. That'll be very beautiful. Hello, my sister, how are you? Okay, let me go around. I've spoken to you already, sir. So let me speak to more people out there. This is live coverage of what is going on in New York. It's we're right in front of the British consulate. The big giant building that they have over here. And this is part of an oil museum. See, this is our building. They fix their home while our own home is useless. Take care. See, this is not their building. Let us show you. See, they have this giant building, belongs to the British government. All they are doing is collect the money from the place. They can build this giant building. Then why we have no roots in our place? Then when we say we want to leave, they won't let us leave. Then we will leave whether they like it or not. Destiny may be divided, but it's over tonight. On Biafra we stand. That's our sister carrying that placard. So many placards. This makes a lot of sense. Destiny may be debated, but never denied. On Biafra we stand. I love that sister. All right. Many more. They are still coming. They are still parading. The young people are even taking part in this too. I'm too happy. All right. I see that. We are parading. Biafra is here. Our family is here. I don't think anybody can do. Before I used to be a few people, but today the crowd is increasing. Oh, I'm so proud of what I'm seeing here. And I encourage them to continue with this. And I'll do everything here. Make sure that I send this message out. Wherever we're going to have this, we need a repeat over and over. Maybe next time we'll have to move to the Kenyan embassy, where they are joining the terrorist government of Nigeria, to make sure that we bring them to justice. Nobody can be sitting down there and allowing himself to be a slave. If things are working out, I don't know what people think. But I don't think that if they do the right thing, that anybody wants to break away. And they say, why do you want to break away? Of course, they say good reason to break away. Nothing is happening. Nobody is taking care of us. See the British consulate. See their house. The building is so high that you need an elevator to climb there. The whole of this building, the whole entire building belongs to them.
All our oil money. Have they not taken enough? They have paid us enough. It will allow us to go. All right with this, my dear brothers. Okay, let me see if I can come to you. Somebody I want to really speak to. Although he has spoken before, charity, but all I need to say is that Biafra is here to stay.
God bless. God bless.
All right, thank you, my brothers. I go up the air this time. We have to continue some other time. The holding has come to an end.